Hi guys, welcome back. Today we'll be discussing a very interesting but a brief topic, that is about virus. We already know that virus is responsible for causing many infectious diseases, right? Now, what are the characteristics of viruses? Viruses are considered to be on the borderline of non-living and living organisms. And why is that? They're considered to be non-living because of their nature, that is crystalline. Now we already know the different elements are present in the form of crystal, which are non-living, right? Just like a salt, that is crystalline in nature. Similarly, viruses are crystalline in nature and therefore they are considered to be non-living. But they are considered to be living because of the presence of DNA or in RNA. At the center, there is always a presence of either a DNA or an RNA, which is covered by a protein coat that is represented with this pink crystalline shape structure. And this is a protein coat. So they are considered to be non-living because of their nature, that is crystalline nature, but they are considered living because of the presence of DNA or RNA that is covered by a protein coat. On the other hand, viruses are acellular in nature. What do you mean by acellular? Acellular meaning they have no cellular organization. They have no cellular organization. And another question, that how do they reproduce? Viruses are basically considered to be parasites. And they use other living organism as host. They live inside their body. They use their mechanism for shelter and food, and in turn causes them harm in the form of different infections, right? So these are the characteristics of a virus. But because of their crystalline nature and because they are acellular in nature, viruses are not included in any of the five kingdoms. Why? Because they are acellular and they are on the borderline of living and non-living. Therefore, they are not considered to be a living organism and they are not included in any of the five kingdoms. Now, we have seen this diagram. Which kind of virus is this? That is the question. The name of this virus is bacteriophage virus, right? There is a bacteria in it, but it is not a bacteria, it's a virus. And it consists of an RNA at the center, which is covered by a protein coat, as we have discussed. Yeah? So this was about the viruses. Just like viruses, there are two more organisms, which are prions and viroids. These are acellular in nature, meaning they do not have any cellular organization. And they cause, just like viruses, they cause infectious diseases in the living organisms, thus using them as a host. What about their nature? Prions consist of only proteins in them. What do they consist of? They consist of proteins. Whereas viroids are made up of circular RNA. Yeah? So prions consist of proteins only, whereas viroids consist of circular RNA. So this concludes our topic. We discussed three things. What is the nature of virus? Why is it considered to be at the borderline of living and non-living? And what are its different characteristics? And why is it not included in the five kingdom classification system? And the last thing is the discussion of the two other acellular particles, which are prions and viroids. I hope everything is clear. And let me know in the comment section if you have got any question. Would love to hear back from you. Thank you so much for joining. Subscribe to my channel, like it, share it, and follow me on Instagram. Till next time, stay safe. Bye-bye.